the beautiful Chesapeake Bay oyster. Plump, delicate, with a flavor profile that's described as soft salt. And while they do grow naturally in the wild, an increasing number, like these skinny dippers grown in southern Maryland by True Chesapeake, are produced through something known as aquaculture. Now, if you don't know what aquaculture is, it's basically farming, but on the water. And like farming on land, it all starts with a seed.
At True Chesapeake in Baltimore, they don't just serve oysters, they grow them at a farm in southern Maryland.
It means sustainable production of oysters, as opposed to depending on the wild fishery, we're doing everything ourselves.
To keep the oysters cultivating, they spend upwards of $100,000 a year on oyster seed.
It's a big investment, but it's what makes oyster farming sustainable.
Those seeds come from here, Ferry Cove Shellfish, a state-of-the-art oyster hatchery located on the eastern shore of Maryland, just a few miles from St. Michael's.
It's a need and there's demand.
Stefan Abel is the president of Ferry Cove.
Maryland is one of the few states that still has a wild fishery that operates from October through the end of March. But come 1 April, in between crabbing season, the wild fishery, the watermen, have an opportunity to produce their own oysters and make some extra money before the crabbing season begins.
In 2013, Maryland aquaculture leases produced 22,428 bushels of oysters. 10 years later, that number ballooned to more than 94,000, leading to the need for more oyster seed. It's a problem Abel and his team are looking to solve.
We house about 30 bushels of adult oysters every year, and those are pretty much all the animals we need to produce billions of larvae.
Stephen Weschler is the hatchery manager at Ferry Cove. He walked us through the process of spawning oysters.
We bring in the oysters that we purchase from the commercial industry during the winter, and we stage them into our broodstock room where we acclimate them to a springtime temperature, which they then recognize as time to start thinking about reproduction. And so they sit there for about 2 months.
One final bump in temperature.
About 30 Celsius.
Lets them know it's time to spawn. Jokes aside, it's a science. One female oyster can produce more than 20 million eggs per spawning session. The eggs that get fertilized are known as larvae.
I'm going to show you larvae that are competent and ready to set. So they're going to have their foot out and extended, looking for a place to secrete a glue and attach to.
These larvae are just 2 days old. From here, some will be sold while others will attach to ground up pieces of oyster shell and become oyster seed. They then live in ultra filtered water and are fed a high quality algae until they're about 2 millimeters in size.
All right, let's put into perspective how small these oysters really are. These guys, they're about a month old. They're graded to 2 millimeters. So in this jug, there are 150,000 of them.
Once they're strong enough, they'll be moved outside to live in water straight from the Chesapeake Bay.
This is the last stage before they get sent out to our customers.
Customers like Patrick Hudson and True Chesapeake, who with the water filtering power of oysters, say it's an industry they're proud to be a part of.
It's really rare to be a part of a business that actually has a positive impact on the environment. So the bigger oyster farming gets, the better the impact on the environment.
Now, Abel thinks that Maryland is actually behind when it comes to the aquaculture industry, and they hope to be a part of its growth in the future. Sean Stryker, WBAL-TV 11 News.